Hallelujah. NFC. Can we be on our feet as we pray? I want you to set your heart apart. God is set to not only elevate you, but to make a difference in your life. And Exodus has always been a possible rebellion against the world system, against the system of the devil. And it always takes a man competent enough, a man with sufficient capacity, with sufficient knowledge, to declare an exodus. When you are being able to be salvaged from your family, and only you are able to exceed through the lineage of darkness, you can't call that an exodus. An exodus has to involve a large amount of people, sufficient enough to form a nation. An exodus is likened unto a situation where you forcefully declare that you and your family must be free from the bondage of darkness. But mind you, that declaration is actually a declaration of war. There has never been an exodus without an attendant challenge. So I want us to pray and say, oh God, I have rise as that son and daughter of God. The one that will declare, the one that will proclaim that this bondage has that for so long. Now I'm grown up to capacity. I can now be able to salvage my family from that menace of darkness. If no one dies in your family, I tell you, if you are saved, many others will perish alive. But the day you decide to rise, that devil will not remain for long. Can we pray and say, oh God, let that Egyptian that followed me for so long, today, let them be drowned in the sea. There will always be a Red Sea between you. There will always be a Red Sea before you. There will be some people willing to take your life away. I tell you, if you can rise with that understanding and that mentality, that one with God is majority, and a man that God has helped is better than a man that has helped himself, there will be no devil that will keep you in that bondage for so long. That bondage is supposed to remain as long as you are ignorant of it, and as long as you do not receive sufficient strength from God to mount up to a realm and a cleft where the activity of darkness no longer exists, but you are immune to them. There is a realm such as that, where the thing that they will do might not matter to you so much. Can you pray and say, God, take me to that realm where I will no longer be under the bondage of the devil? That possibility lies in God. That possibility lies, it lies. A man has to rise to declare a curse to the devil. A man has to rise. If you don't rise, your children will suffer it. But if you can break away from it, if you can break away from that yoke,
Kabalia. Arababela to Bomba Kashkebata. Samba Katobalia. Babela to Koba Kashkaba. Samba Katobaliata. Rababela to Papa Kashkata.
Let heaven hear your voice. Let heaven hear your voice. So God, I am the son of God. I am the one that the promise is waiting upon. For the spirit of the Lord is upon me. He has anointed me for this purpose. So for this purpose, is the son of man made manifest, that he might break the yoke of the devil. You can cry
you were dull. Even while the Bible was singing, some of you were asleep. Many more times, trouble you like that. I want to bring a perspective, then we pray. And I believe and trust Lord that certain things will change. Definitely. Sir, you are taking the time. Hallelujah. 1 Corinthians 3. I said Exodus. And Exodus is a forceful rebellion against the system of darkness. And Exodus is a conscious attempt to refuse the hostility of the devil. And Exodus is actually a journey away from the world into God. You will not actually truly be free if you journey from the world into another. Your freedom lies inside of Christ Jesus. And whatsoever you define an Exodus is, the destination did not end in God. I assure you, won't be free. And Exodus is also looked upon as the transition of a large amount of people from one location. Actually, the location is a place of hostility. You can see this. It's a place of hostility. A place where you have been oppressed, you have been suppressed. A place where you have been tortured. The day you are free from such a place, you don't just get the freedom. Freedom is for one person. But when it involves so many people, it's regarded as an exodus. And I said that we cannot tag Exodus as Exodus if only you are the only one that escaped. No. That's what we are not of. A hostility is referred to as Christ's condition. Like the situation that we saw by the river of Babylon when the children of Israel were taken as captives. And they were being tormented and demanded to sing a song that would save them at that time. But there was no help from nowhere. Because God was involved in their captivity. We also saw through sleep to how when Pharaoh went after the children of Israel, there was a Red Sea before them. And here we are chariots behind them. At that time, you will understand the benefits of freedom. A hostile situation is a situation that is actually not friendly. I don't think it should be friendly. And most times we regard to it as an enemy. But let's come back to this. A lot of us are into all kinds of things. And like I said, to be in captivity, you don't really need a chain and an anchor. It's just an oppression of darkness. When you are in a situation where Paul said that there are things that I want to do that I find myself not doing, and there are things that I do not want to do and I find myself doing, at that time, you are actually under the law of sin and death, where your life is manipulated by an empire, a greater authority higher than you, something that went ahead of your will. Maybe it began with your will. Many more times, captivity will always begin with your will. You will first of all submit to the thinking that peradventure is a life. But later on, you discover they are taking a play. That even you can survive. If you must actually realize how to come out of captivity, you must understand that there is a law of the spirit of life in Christ Jesus. There is a law that Christ has set in place that will help you come out of captivity. Because all of us, we are once upon a time captive. But thank God, there was deliverance. 1 Corinthians. Paul speaking, say, and I, brethren, could not speak unto you as unto spiritual, but as unto carnal, even as unto babes. Follow me. I will try to minimize time. That means I will pass time. From that, realize that Paul was defining the state of which they are. That there were things that he wanted to speak unto them that are spiritual. But he cannot be able to communicate to them because they are. What was the thing that he was trying to communicate here? It was actually what he was speaking about in chapter 12. As of this time, they do not have the capacity. They do not have the wiring, the mechanism in them to contain the speakings of the manifestations of the activity of the Spirit of God. And everything you saw him communicate in chapter 12, if he has spoken it to them now, they will never have been able to hear. Why? They are under a captive. At any time a man is under captivity, or doing one again, he becomes a carnal being. One who cannot dictate of his own self. One who is not led by the Spirit of God. One who his flesh has become the driving force for his life. And Paul said that I have fed you with milk and not with meat. For it at all you were not able to bear it. Neither yet now are ye able. For ye are yet carnal. For whereas there is among you envy, strife, and divisions, are ye not carnal and walk as men? Their carnality is you, they are walking as men. It's a question for them to answer. And the things that make them carnal were not important, feed their spirit. Not that they were not praying, they were praying. But simple things make them carnal. They were not only but divided, but they were divided among their divisions. And how can they be able to get the things of God? The things of God communicated to people, to a set of people, was only by faith. If they are united, one in heart and in spirit. Verse 16. Say, know ye not that ye are the temple of God, and that the Spirit of God dwell in you? We see another question mark here again. He said, if any man defile the temple of God, him shall God destroy. For the temple of God is holy, which temple ye are. My emphasis is, know ye not that ye are the temple of God. What was it that they don't do? Because what made them carnal was their not knowing that they were actually the temple of God. So they divide themselves. So they engage in unholy alliances with the devil. That compromised their spiritual stand. And they became carnal. When Paul met them, he had to realize and bring them to that understanding of soul realization. That they don't actually know that they are the temple of God. And that the Spirit of God dwells inside of them. That they are supposed to be a carrier of a spirit that is holy. But what was it that they don't know? If you go to the book of Psalms 82, from 5. David captured that. I believe that's what David captured is true. As a man after God's own heart. The Bible said that they don't know. Neither will they even understand. Does it look alike with the other scripture? And I say they walk on in darkness, and all the foundations of the earth are out of course. So the problem in the Old Testament, very simple, that the problem of mankind is that they don't know. The problem of people being in captivity and in bondage is that they don't know. A man said something, that I have freed 1,000 slaves, right? And I could have freed more if they only know that they were slaves. Something like that, right? Many more times, the first step to your deliverance is to know that actually you can. If you deny the reality that something is troubling you, you will never come. Because you have already lied to yourself. So the first thing that I believe that they don't know is that they don't know that God actually is dwelling in them. And as a result of God dwelling in them, He's giving them the ability that He has and His capacity to function as benign, or you can say God. So if you have the understanding that you are actually a product of God, you are actually part of God, you are in the image and the likeness of God, it is impossible for what cannot hold God bound to hold you bound. And they don't also know that there is a dimension of God hidden inside of them that is beyond the understanding of man. As you are like this, I bet you don't even know yourself. Many of you think only the things that people told you. There are many things about you that you don't know. Maybe some of them have communicated to you dreams and encounters. But the true essence, your true nature lies in another realm, which is trapped inside of you. And until you take a journey inside of God, you might never actually realize that there is something about you alone. Do you know that if you have not come to every study chemistry, when you were born, you never know that you can become a chemist or a pharmacist yourself? The same way that those things were fashioned in you and they were brought out of you, in the same way that there is a lot of investment that God has put inside of you that no one knows. And if you have not taken a journey inside of God, you might never actually get to find those things. And those things not being able to come across a bondage. Because you live in the reality of your life so long. So you must understand that there are dimensions in you that even the devil or no man can be able to comprehend. And you have to depend upon God to be able to bring those things out. The second emphasis should be on, and that the Spirit of God dwelleth. The Bible says, first of all, they don't really know. And they don't also know that there is a Spirit that dwells in them. Like I said, Paul was speaking to brethren. People that were born again, they were filled with the Holy Spirit. But somehow, they don't actually know that there is a Spirit inside of them. Because many of you think that there has to be something bigger than what you see. Every man that you see succeed in God do not have a different Holy Spirit than the one you have. The problem is that you don't know the capacity of the Holy Spirit. You don't know to what extent that Holy Spirit can go. And your ignorance has fashioned the strength that the devil is using to keep you captive. That captivity will remain for so long as long as I. The Bible said that the Lord God is that Spirit. And wherever the Spirit of God is, there is liberty. If God is that Spirit, and if He dwells inside of you, Him just dwelling inside of you is supposed to guarantee liberty. him being able to stay inside of you is about to put you above the activity of darkness. If you can learn how to take advantage of the Holy Spirit inside of you. And the Bible said that because they do not know, they have rendered the foundation of creation to be out of course. That your ignorance has the ability to distort creation. If all of us are under the control level, you know that creation itself will be in the greater order. In the sense that, who will deliver us, all of us as bodies? The essence to which Christ Jesus was crucified, dead and buried, will be defeated. The ignorance of the princes was what enabled the devil to keep people in bondage. And the Bible said that that made the foundation of the earth to be out of course. But you will be aware that there are many foundations on the earth. If English mean anything, that scripture said the foundations of the earth. Look at 1 Corinthians 3 from 9. Paul said, for we are laborers together with God. Ye are God's husbandry, ye are God's building. According to the grace of God which is given unto me, as a wise master builder, I have laid the foundation, and another buildeth upon thereon. But let every man take heed now how he buildeth upon. For other foundation can no man lay than that is laid, which is Christ Jesus. So we see the sure foundation to be Christ Jesus. But when he went further, he expressed to us that he said, now, if any man build upon this foundation, gold, silver, precious stones, wood, or hay, or stubble, that none of this will stand. That is impossible for you to build your life upon a lie. That all your life, live chasing money. You will live chasing a lot of kind of things. But if you lack the understanding that your foundation is supposed to be in God, then that captivity, I assure you, will remain for so long. Quickly before I run, Bible says, and ye are Christ, and Christ is God. That if your foundation is Christ, then you also have been given the privilege to be poor as Christ. And if you are born in Christ, then you also carry a nature of God. And that simply means that for you to actually discover yourself, you have to first of all take a journey into Christ. Then take another journey into God. Then God reveal himself to you. Then in the revealing of himself to you, then you now see yourself. That's why 2 Corinthians 3, 17 says, the Lord is that spirit, and where the spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. But he now says that we all, with an open face, as we behold the glory of God, we are now being changed into that same image that we are seeing from glory to glory. How can you be changed if you don't behold the image of God? Your transformation lies in your ability to be able to see the true image and nature of God. Because until you see that, you yourself can actually discover yourself. The Bible says he called them gods unto whom the word of God came. And that the scriptures are not the proof. You see, have I not said that ye are God? That's our faith. Have I not said that ye are God? And that all of you are children of the Most High. But you can also die like mere men and perish simply because you don't. And I said, one of the greatest things that you have to know is that the foundation of our liberation lies inside of Christ Jesus. Anytime you make a call away from Christ Jesus, I assure you, captivity awaits you. If you look through the life of the children of Israel, anytime they pray for constant, they always fall into the hand of God. And when they call back again, he come and deliver them again. I want us to pray and return again to the place of our refuge. Like men and women that have deviated from the true foundation. The journey always has to start from a discovery of God. I want us to pray. Through God, I have exhausted a lot of priorities for you. Of who I am inside of you has led me into this. And the challenge is that you continue in so long in exploring darkness, you will not only denature yourself, you will denature the nature of God. And for God not to be denatured, God may love you. Make sure that he pervert the whole of creation so that God cannot but do with no man. And if God can see that there is no one that can carry his nature, he will destroy the earth. I assure you. That is why men and women that will not bow to the deceitfulness of darkness must have to rise. People that must declare allegiance unto God and declare a forceful rebellion against darkness. Can you rise as you pray? We are going to enter a session of prayer. I want your heart to be set. There is nothing that I said that you don't know. Seeing that, just like the way Paul reminded them, that you are filled with the Holy Ghost, but you don't know the capacity of the Holy Spirit inside of you. That you are actually in the image and the likeness of God, but you do not know. And as a result of your ignorance, you are bondage. Because the place of your bondage is actually the place of your ignorance. The day that light and revelation comes, you can't remain in bondage again.